Welcome to the television ministry of Souls Harbor Tabernacle. We are located in the shadow of beautiful Crowder's Mountain, 271 Camp Rotary Road, Gastonia, North Carolina. Now be blessed by the anointed ministry of Pastor James Chambers and Church.
Well, praise the Lord. So good to be with you tonight. We appreciate you tuning in to TV broadcast tonight on this Saturday night program. I'd like to invite you to be at church with us in the morning. Our service starts at 11 tomorrow night. It's at 6 o'clock, and Wednesday night is 7 o'clock. We'd love to have you at any of our services. Have a great church over in Dallas, North Carolina. Brother Eric Quinn, his wife Arlene, labors for the Lord there, and they will be at their services tomorrow. Sunday school at 9:30, 10:30 preaching, and 6 o'clock tomorrow night for their worship service. They have Tuesday night service at 7 o'clock, and they'd be glad to have you at any of their services. Up the road at Souls Harbor Tabernacle of Mooresburg, Brother Chuck Poole and his wife Joyce labor for the Lord there. And at present time, they're only having services on Sunday. Their morning worship is at 11 and Sunday night at 6 o'clock. They'd love to have you there. And again, Betty and I would love to see you at the Gastonia Church if you could. We got Charlie going to sing a song for us tonight, and we're going to let her come and sing it in just a moment, but I just want to make a couple announcements. I want to dedicate this to my wife, Betty, to all of my sisters. They love Charlie. That's their niece, Betty, Louise, Geraldine, and Marcella and their families. And I believe Hunter Shook is home this week, and that's Betty's grandson, and he's just a precious young man, and he loves me, and he loves the Lord as best he can. And if he's home tonight, we dedicate this to Hunter Shook. Dedicated to Ernest and Mary Earp. They love to hear music. And Charlie's going to sing three songs for us tonight on the broadcast. And I'm just so glad to have her with us. Also dedicate this to my good friend Jim Griffin and his wife. If they're listening tonight, they also love Charlie. And let me just tell you, Charlie and Tim is going to be in charge or doing the services tomorrow for me. They're going to be preaching and singing, ministering in both services. And I thought it would be good to let you hear Charlie. Some people know her. She's been my child for 40-some years, and she's helped us in the ministry. But her and her husband still help us in the ministry. Tim and the girls, they help us, but a lot of times they're just involved in other ministries, and they just can't get here every service. They sing with groups. They both speak and minister, and they help with youth groups. And so we're just honored to have them with us both times tomorrow. And you'd love to be there if you could. 11 o'clock, 6 o'clock. We'd be so glad to have you there. Listen to Charlie. She sings her first song.
Thank you for having us in your home tonight. We hope that everything will do is a blessing. At the end of this life, all that matters is that you can stand before the Lord and know in your heart that you chose Jesus while you were here on this earth.
Has they gambled for the road he wore? They chose the worldly trade, but they didn't think of eternity as those soldiers drove the nails. And do we learn from what they've done or make the same mistakes? Is it me or the world, my child? He said, which one will you take? I'll take Jesus. Jesus, you see, I've tried those worldly pleasures and they fail. And when we see the gates of heaven and hear the Master say, is it me or the world, my child? Which one did you take? You're gonna hear me
Enjoyed that song. We appreciate Charlie being here tonight. She's going to be back in just a moment to sing another song. And I want to invite you and ask you if you would to write us, pray for us. If you could help us with a love offer, we sure would appreciate that. This program is supported totally by faith. The church will help if they need to, but right now we're in a position where we just is supported by the people that watch it. We appreciate it. God so richly blesses. So just help us as you can. Any size will be appreciated and accepted. We're going to have Charlie sing another song at this time.
This is one of my favorite songs, so I hope you enjoy it.
Helpless man, lying from birth, the only one who saw his work didn't pass in vain. Oh, he heard his cry, so he rubbed his eyes with a handful of clay, and he said, "Go and wash by the pool today." And that blind man knew just what he had to do. And all along the way, he couldn't help but trip and fall. But each time he got back up again, I wonder if he thought that every step I take is a step of faith. When I can't see what's in front of me, I walk on and just believe he hears my prayer. And when I get there, the miracle promised by my Father is waiting in the water. I walked in darkness, I won't lie, and just like that blind man, sometimes I felt alone, just like all hope is gone. Oh, but I know that his word is true, and no matter what I'm going through, he promised me that he would never leave. Though along the way I may stumble and I may fall, but I'll make it to that water, even if I have to grow. 'Cause every step I take is a step of faith. When I can't see what's in front of me, I won't go on and just believe he hears my prayer. And when I get there, the miracle promised by my Father is waiting in the water. It's all in his plan. So until my healing comes, I'll keep pressing on. Every step I take, it is a step of faith. When I can't see what's in front of me, I'll walk on and just believe he hears my prayer. And when I get there, the miracle promised by my Father is waiting in the water. It's waiting in the water.
praise your meals.
Well, praise the Lord. I hope you enjoyed that song. Don't forget that I told you Charlie and Tim French, and my daughter Charlie, and their girls, Abby and Lauren, will be singing and ministering in the morning and tomorrow night at our church. And I'd ask you to make an effort to get there for one of the services. If you can't be there, be sure to string with us, and we appreciate it. Go and let Charlie sing another song for you at this time.
I was going to the well like every other day, not knowing that my life was gonna change. There I met a man who told of living water. He said that I could drink and never thirst again. He was waiting for me at the well. He knew where I was and what I would need. Lord, give me a drink of that water, oh, living water. Let it flow to me for everlasting life.
Praise the Lord. Hope you enjoyed those three songs by Charlie tonight. And we're just going to try to obey the Lord in the next few minutes as we can. Don't have very long left, but we have some time. We have maybe a dozen minutes left. And so I'm going to attempt to share with you what I shared with the church this past Sunday night. And I felt the Lord laid on my heart. And I want to tell you, the message is about 9 or 10 pages long, so I can't do it in its entirety in 10 or 12 minutes. But I'm going to attempt to just give you the highlight. And I will tell you, if you like this message, you can get on our Facebook and look at Sunday night's program. I believe it's the 16th on Sunday night is the date, but it's the past Sunday night. And you can look on there and you can hear this message in its entirety. But I want to just share the word with you tonight just a little bit from 1 Peter 5, chapter 5, verse 6 through 9. And I preached the other night on the subject, your adversary. Let me read the scripture. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, is as a roaring lion, walking about, seeking whom he may devour, whom resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. Amen. God bless the word tonight, and we thank you for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let me just share a little bit, just maybe touch on, might not get no further than the scriptures in 10 minutes or 12 minutes, but you just worship with us, and if you want to hear the rest of this, it is on Sunday night, this program, the past Sunday night's program on Facebook. You can watch it. Amen. He said to humble ourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. I think a lot of folks have a lot of trouble with humbling themselves. I mean, you know, I can do this. Get back out of the way. I'll handle it. And I'm telling you, I cannot do nothing without him. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. But I can't do nothing without him. Amen. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God. You don't have to let men and women knock you around and boss you around, but you ought to humble yourself before this almighty God, casting all your care upon him, for he cared for you. That means your worries and your thoughts and your cares and your children and your wife and your husband and the church and the preacher and all your family. Every care, bottle them up in one thing and just say, God, here's all my cares. I'm going to give them all to you tonight. Amen. Because he cared for you. Amen. The devil beats many of us up by telling us nobody don't care for us. Nobody cares for you. It don't matter to me what you do. Do what you want to do. That kind of thing. That's all right if that's the way you feel. But I'm telling you, you will never be without someone who cares for you. If the world turns against you, if the church kicks you out, if you're not allowed to speak or preach in your church or sing in your church, you have to sit there like a knot on the log and can't do nothing. I'm here to tell you, there's someone that cares for you. And he gave us a disclaimer in these two verses, or I feel like it is. I feel like it's a disclaimer that he puts on there and tells us that before he tells us how about the devil and how he's going to come against you, he tells us to humble ourselves before God, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Again, I think people have trouble humbling themselves, and I feel like they want to be exalted themselves. And I think another thing that we have a problem with in that verse is we don't like God's time. But his ways is above our ways. He may be 4 days late in your book, but he's an on-time God. Yes, he is. And then verse 7, just casting all your care on him, for he cares for you. And then the heart of the message, I started just to use this one verse. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil. He's not your devil, but he is your adversary. He is your enemy. He's not my devil. Don't nobody lead him off on me. He's on his own tonight. Amen. I love the Lord and everything that the Lord has. And I know that all my hope is in Jesus. And the devil, I ain't got time for the devil. One song writer said, ain't got time for the devil. Amen. And I don't. But he comes at you as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour, walking about. He can't read your mind. The Bible said the eyes of the Lord go over to and fro over there, but the devil has to walk himself around, and he's not the only one. He has demons. Sometimes we think it's the devil, and we might not even, a devil might not even know where we live, but well, some of his imps do, some of his angels do, some of the demons do, and they will come around. And then he said, you've got to remain steadfast in the faith. Amen. I'm telling you, you just have to keep going, line on line, precept on precept. You have to put one foot in front of the other. You just have to keep going. You just have to say, I'm not going to stop. I refuse to stop. I'm going to keep going and keep going and keep going. That's what you have to do. Be steadfast. That means be instant in season. Have a season. Just don't quit. Amen. If you fall down, get up. If you get knocked down, get up. If somebody puts you down, get over it. Amen. Get up and get walking for the Lord one more time. Amen. I believe it's important that you do that. Be steadfast. Be steadfast what? In the faith. If you believe God's going to do something for you, don't you let nobody talk you out of it. You just remain on to that and hold on to that, because the devil himself will do everything he can to steal your faith. Amen. And faith is one of the most important tools we have as a Christian. You remember when Jesus told Peter that the devil is going to try you and sift you as wheat, but I prayed for you that your faith don't fail. He didn't even say, I prayed for you that you don't fail. I prayed for you that you hold on to the faith, that you'll keep walking in faith. Amen. And that's what we're to do. Amen. And that's what Peter did. Peter did fail. He was exalted in himself just a little bit. He said, not me. You must be talking about somebody else. I'm not going to fail you. Well, Jesus didn't change his word. He said, yeah, you're going to fail me. You're going to deny me three times. And he did. And after he did that, amen, he remembered his words and he got things back right with God. I'm telling you, why? Because his faith never did fail. I mean, he failed, he quit, he didn't show up at church. He went fishing when God told him to go pray. He went fishing, and a lot of people followed him and went fishing with him. You know the story in the Bible. But God just told him, he said, I pray for you that your faith don't fail. God knows our heart. Man looks on the outward appearance, but God knows our heart. And God looked at Peter, and he saw what he was, amen, and what he could be. And he would have never stood up on the day of Pentecost and got all those souls saved if he'd have quit, if he'd have sat down. But God knew where he wanted to take him, and he knew where he was going to go with Peter. And so he said, I just prayed for you that your faith don't fail. If you quit, if you lay out of church two or three services, get back in there. If you say, I'm not going to preach no more, get back in there. My heart's hungry tonight to tell you, don't quit. Don't let the devil get you down. Don't let the devil get you out. I'm telling you, I feel like there's people, and I think there's times when he has me or my wife counted us out and said, 1, 2, 3, 4, and if the count was 10, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and before I got to the 10th count, I think the Holy Ghost showed up. This God that says, I care for you. Amen. Be steadfast in the faith. I care for you. Amen. Be steadfast in the faith. And knowing in our mind, clearly understanding, that we're not the only one going through these trials. Amen. If you're sick, if you got a wife or husband that won't do right, got a boss on your job that won't do right, ain't got money to pay your bills, I'm telling you, if you're discouraged, if you're ready to hang your harp up on a willow tree like the children of Israel did when they were in Babylonian territory and they lost their song and the devils made fun of you, sing us one of them songs. Preach now, preacher. Do whatever you can do now. Just go ahead. Somehow or another, it may look like sometime I've lost it. And people say, well, Brother Chambers is gone. And then you'll see my hand come back. And then you'll see me raise up. And then you'll see another hand come up. And another hand come up. Get my feet firm on the ground again. And I'll start back preaching. I can't tell you I don't get discouraged. I can't tell you that I don't have many toils and snares. But amazing grace has brought me through those things. And it'll bring you through those things. But you got to work with it. I heard Brother Lane say one time, and Shady Lane, most folks in Gastonia know him. He said one time that God will use anything that you give him. And he'll understand. He'll take your hand. But when you release God from his obligation of taking care of you, is when you terminate your relationship with God. When you stop. Then you're just on the mercies of God. And the Bible says it's a fearful thing to fall in the hands of a living God. And that's where you're at if you're lost tonight. If you don't know Jesus, you're there. But the same afflictions, the same trials that other people have, you have them, I have them, we all have them. Somebody say amen. I believe that's right. Amen. The same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren, not just in people. I know you tell somebody about your problem, they'll tell you their daughter had that, their son had that. You know, a sickness or a disease, you file bankruptcy, somebody said, well, I did that, so-and-so did that 3 times. That's not what you want to hear, amen? You just want to understand that you're not the only one going through this, amen? And God brought them out, and he'll bring you out, amen? The testimony, the Bible said we overcome by the blood of the Lamb. That's all you got to have to make it. And then the word of our testimony. Amen. It could just be for you saying, I'm going through. I started out for heaven. I'm going through. I don't regret a mile of travel for the Lord. I don't regret a time. I've trusted his word. Seen the years go by, many days without a song. But I still do not regret a mile the travel for the Lord. And I don't plan on quitting. Amen. Somebody hear me tonight. I know that. Amen. They're in the world. Brother Gordon Stacy said, you got to have contact without contamination. Amen. I think that's what you got to have. You can't, you know, some people just say, well, I ain't going over there. I ain't going to do that. I ain't going to watch no TV. And that takes the preachers off too, you know. Whatever you do, you can have absolutes. I'm not going to do that anymore. But, you know, he said, realize that your brethren's going through the same thing and you can make it. Is our prayer tonight. Want to hear this message in its entirety. Last Sunday night, we preached this at our church called Your Adversary. About 7 or 8 pages of notes. If you want to hear it all, go on Facebook and hear that message. Charlie and Tim's going to be with us in the morning and tomorrow night singing and ministering in both services. And she's been with us tonight. If you enjoyed her singing, come out tomorrow. If you can't get out tomorrow, then stream with us. Amen. And listen to the word of God being preached by them. I'm not sure which one's going to preach which, but they're going to sing and minister in both services. You don't want to miss it. Father, bless those who've called in tonight, and bless this ministry, and bless the services tomorrow. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for joining us on the telecast. Pastor Chambers, wife Betty, and entire congregation welcome you to any of our exciting services. Morning worship, 11 a.m., Sunday evening, 6 p.m., and Wednesday at 7. Tune in next time.